2016, to the Hall News Tribune and the Clerk of the City of New Brunswick. The time and location of this meeting and all meetings of this body are posted in City Hall, 78 Lyon Street, New Brunswick. Roll call, Mr. Fanneron.
Mrs. Fowler?
Here.
Mr. Hush?
Here.
Mr. Ortiz?
Here.
Mrs. Sadowski?
Excused.
Mrs. Shukitis?
Here.
Mr. Spencer?
Here.
Mrs. Morella?
Here.
Mr. Caldwell?
Here.
Mrs. Seawood?
Here.
Have a form.
Thank you.
Ready to vote?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic of which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Reminder, the next monthly Board of Education meeting will be held on Tuesday, August 16th, 2016, beginning at 7 p.m. at this location. At this time, we're going to add something to the agenda. Mr. Johnson?
At this time, we'd like to defer to Ms. Fowler.
So with a heavy heart today, I am resigning from the Board of Education. I want to thank my fellow board members for their guidance and support in my decision to resign. It was a great honor to serve alongside such a committed group of individuals with a vested interest in the success of our district and our city. I am grateful I had the opportunity to bring about positive change in this district. One of the decisions which I'm extremely proud of is the appointment of our new superintendent. I am sure that he will continue to contribute positively to the success of our city and our district. Although I am saddened to be stepping down, I will continue in my commitment to the city and remain an active member of our community. I look forward to serving alongside of you again in the future. Thank you so much.
Ms. Fowler, as a token of appreciation, New Brunswick Public School District would like to present to you a small little gift.
I would now be excusing myself. Thank you.
Next item on the agenda is number 3, approval of minutes. Can we have one motion?
Yes.
Yes. May I have a motion for approval of the June 16th, June 21st, and June 30th meetings? Mr. General.
Mr. Hush.
Yes.
Ortiz?
Yes.
Mr. Spencer?
Yes.
Ms. Varela?
Yes.
Mr. Caldwell?
Yes.
Mrs. Seawood?
Yes.
Motion approved.
Thank you. Superintendent's report. Mr. Arthur Johnson.
Yes, good evening. For the month of June, we had 130 district-wide suspensions. We had 12 cases of harassment, intimidation, and bullying. Our student enrollment at the end of the year was 10,118 students. Our student attendance rate was at 94%, and our staff attendance rate was at 95.5%. Thank you. That concludes my portion.
Motion.
So moved.
Second.
Mr. Hush.
Yes.
Mr. Ortiz.
Yes.
Mr. Spencer.
Yes.
Ms. Varela.
Yes.
Mr. Caldwell.
Yes.
Mrs. Seawood. Motion approved.
Facilities Committee report.
Yes, Madam President, we did not meet this month. The next month, we will report the facility. Thank you.
The Policy Committee report, Mr. Ortiz.
The Policy Committee did not meet, Madam President, so there's no report to give this month.
Mr. Hush with the Athletic Committee report.
Yes, motion to accept the athletic report for April, May, and June. We did not meet for a month of July, and also bank reconciliation. Motion to accept.
Move to accept the resolution, the financial report.
Oh, this is athletic.
Athletic.
Second.
Mr. Hush.
Yes.
Mr. Ortiz.
Yes.
Mr. Spencer.
Yes.
Ms. Varela.
Yes.
Mr. Caldwell.
Yes.
Mrs. Seawood.
Yes.
Motion approved.
Next is the Curriculum Committee report. Mr. Ortiz.
Yes, Madam President, the Curriculum Committee did meet. We had no presentations at the time. We did have discussion on some revisions to curriculum for 6th, 7th, 8th grade, sciences, math, and advanced sciences and math. And we also had discussion on the talented and gifted 4th and 5th grade program. We had some questions to ask about how the program's going to be run, how our kids are going to be selected to be in the program. And so there was interaction there. Other than that, there's nothing else to report for that. For that. We did have reviews of resolutions, which are part of the consent agenda items. We'll vote at that time.
Okay. Thank you. For public relations, I don't have a report. Does anyone have any items they want to highlight? Okay. Mr. Del Caldwell, Ed Services Commission.
Thank you, Madam President. I have no report this month.
Thank you. Now it's time for the President's report. I actually have not prepared anything. However, just for the record, I want to highlight the thought that words matter. The last few weeks, actually the last few months in this country have been rift with unrest, with all types of unspeakable horror, violence precipitated, perpetrated by thoughtless words, deeds, vicious acts. As a community, I want us all to come together, stop the madness, and just reflect on how we treat each other. How do we speak to and about each other. All persons are to be treated with dignity, honor, and respect. So watch how you speak to each other. A little kindness goes a long way. And there's no way this country is going to come together unless we start recognizing the inherent worth of all humanity. As a board, we have come a long way in the last 20 years, and I have been here almost 20 years. Many of the changes that have been implemented are a result of our direct appeal to the administration and the staff to treat our students as if they were, in fact, their own children, worthy of the highest honor. One, I never use the words that we're an urban district. For a woman of color, I know what that buzzword means. We don't have to tell our children that we are a poverty-stricken school district. That doesn't give any positive message to our children, to our students, that they can achieve. They do have dreams, and we are here to make sure we do everything we can to support, to give guidance, to further the educational process. And the last thought I want to leave with you is the fact that support and approval are not the same. I support you, even though I don't always approve of your behavior. But I support your rights. And that's my message to you this evening. Open questions from the public.
Hi, I'm Linda Stork. It wasn't working. I live on Goldberg. I wanted to know about the fourth and fifth grade gifted and talented that you said you had spoken about in the committee. Is that like the program was before, where kids come from all over the district and they're there in a self-contained classroom, or is it a pull-out program? Or is that what is changing?
Yes, our new program is going to be a school within a school located at the Lincoln School on Bartlett Street. The first two grades we're starting with are fourth and fifth. We've identified students from all of the elementary schools in the district, and we're going to be housing them all at the Lincoln School, and it'll be a full day, full year program.
Like the one that we had before?
Very similar. I think that the curriculum is is a lot stronger than it was previously.
Okay, because that's what I was going to ask you, was the takeaway from the previous program that had been successful? Because for some reason it was changed to a different type of program.
I think it builds upon and improves upon what we had before.
And is superior to what's in place now?
Good evening, members of the board. Charles Cradville, Brunswick Today newspaper. I have to begin with an apology. I really regret that I waited until today to contact the Middlesex County Office of Health Services about getting lead tests for the blood of the children who might have drank the contaminated water in the schools. And unfortunately, the answer I got was that they only offer free testing for children under 5, but if I had reached out before the end of June, they would have been happy because they had a grant and they wanted to test as many people of all ages as possible. And I would suggest that I regret not calling sooner, and you know, when I'm done with my remarks, I'd like to hear from the board on why no one at the board reached out to the county. That's what Highland Park did when they found lead in their water, and the children were tested, and it was done for free. And you know, I regret framing it as something that needed to be paid for when I asked questions to the board. I didn't know that this was an option, and so I'm sorry for that. I'm glad you mentioned that you've been on the board for 20 years, because I know that means you were there in 2005 when the EPA teamed up with the schools to do testing. I know that, I guess, 6 different schools, I think, had lead in the water. And I wanted to ask, when that happened, did you notify the staff or parents when you identified the problem? Or did you wait until months later when it had been resolved to tell the parents and the staff?
We'll take your comments under advisement. I'm not going to answer any questions on that issue at this time, Mr. Rao.
Okay, so you were here on the board, but you won't say whether or not what you told people about it. Okay, well, in light of that information, you had information that was not only lead in the water at the Lincoln School, but also here at the McKinney School, near here, 5 faucets, one as high as 35, amount of lead, 6 faucets at the New Brunswick High School, which is now the middle school. 38 was the highest, 3 faucets in the Roosevelt School, 45 is the highest, and then 4 faucets, 51 the highest at Lincoln School, which was actually revisited in 09, and then Livingston School, 2 faucets as high as 52, and then Woodrow Wilson, 4 faucets as high as 53. Why didn't you insist on doing follow-up testing in future years? What happened was Lincoln School was tested again in 2009, and Mr. Janero mentioned that was because there was some work being done in the school. There was concern over air contamination, and they also decided that, hey, we'll test the water too. But why, for all these other schools where lead was found in 2005, didn't you do follow-up testing until 2014, when a reporter filed an OPR request asking to see the results? Why didn't the board think that this was important, knowing that you had this information back from 2005?
Same answer. We'll take your comments under advisement, Mr. Radwell. Thank you.
Okay. I really don't understand why, after all these years, you still have the same attorney who, you know, I can only imagine what is said in executive session. Why wouldn't the board immediately seek to remedy any health problems that have been caused from the lead? Highland Park did it, other districts did it. It just makes sense. When you find it, you should offer testing so the students get it. And it took a long time to get any type of answer out of the board as to why not. But as early as May 5th, Mr. Heckrich, your attorney, was outright saying no. And so I can only imagine that the cause, the reason, must be that you don't want to saying that, that you tried to remedy the problem. But in fact, what you are doing by being negligent is making any civil suit case against the district stronger. You're actually doing the opposite of what I suspect you're trying to do here. And it's really, people's health is at risk here. I don't know why you wouldn't just contact the Middlesex County Office of Health Services, make arrangements for it, make a day of it, and let anybody who wants to get a test get a free test. It was stated at the last meeting that Mrs. Dowski wants to have the kids go to their pediatricians first, and if they can afford it, if they can get there, then and only then does she really want to pursue this. And I know she's not here, but she stated that she wants to hear that there's actually people demonstrating symptoms of lead poisoning. She stated on the record at the last meeting that those symptoms are nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. And I would like to just correct the record that according to the Mayo Clinic, only vomiting is one of the symptoms of lead poisoning. The others are developmental delay, learning difficulties, irritability, loss of appetite, weight loss, sluggishness, and fatigue, abdominal pain, vomiting, as we said, constipation, hearing loss. So if parents think that their children are experiencing these symptoms, I encourage them to heed Mrs. Dowski's call and bring that to the board's attention so that we can get moving on this. And I would like to hear from the board why, what is the logic behind not simply offering this service to people who might have been poisoned? Why won't the board do this? It just seems like the right thing to do here. If this is how the board's going to respond to these serious concerns, I think you should follow the lead of Ms. Fowler and resign if you're not up for the job. I've said my piece here. You guys know that this is a problem, and I didn't hear anything. I heard the facilities committee didn't bother to have a meeting while this is going on. I didn't hear anything about this. Proactive attempts to address the faucets that were exceeding 15. I don't see the board being proactive. It's the opposite, and let's just be honest. The people deserve better. I have to ask and follow up on our discussion at the last meeting, and I need to know, did anybody look into whether or not the New Brunswick Today newspaper is being blocked by the security software at the high school for people using the computers?
It's currently not blocked. I did.
Okay, thank you very much for doing that. I think it's an important resource that people need to be able to have that. And I want to just encourage the board to avail yourself of that resource and send us information about the things that are going on that you would like to see in the news. We're happy to do those stories. It's just we've had some trouble dealing with your contractor, the Success Communications Group, and they have not really been forthcoming or helpful, even when we're trying to do good stories. So I'd like to hear from the board, whenever you have something that you want to put before the public, and just standing offer on the table that if you ever want to write something for us, we will be happy to share it with our readers because we think it's important that the community has stronger connections with the Board of Ed. That's why we're videotaping these meetings and why we encourage you to do the same and be more transparent. Thank you for your time, and please revisit the issue of testing the children. I think it's important.
Consent agenda items A through AN. Resolutions. Could I have a motion?
Mr. Hush?
Yes.
Mr. Ortiz?
Yes.
Mr. Spencer?
Yes.
Ms. Varela?
Yes.
Mr. Caldwell?
Yes.
Yes. Motion approved.
Thank you. The Finance Committee report. Oops. Who's on the Finance Committee with? Mr. General?
So the Finance Report you have in front of you has May's financial report and the bills list and the year-end transfers that we have. So those was what I shared with you before. So there's no resolution on that.
Okay. We need a motion to approve.
Yes, I would do that.
Yes.
So moved.
Second. Mr. Hush?
Yes.
Ms. Ortiz?
Yes.
Mr. Spencer?
Yes.
Ms. Varela?
Yes.
Mrs. Seewood?
Yes.
Motion approved.
Okay.
Yes. Yes.
Mr. Caldwell?
Pull on Bridge? Bridge?
Yes.
I abstain on page one.
So noted.
Okay. 15. Resolution for a closed session. Whereas the Open Public Meeting Act provides that certain matters of the public body may be discussed in closed session. And whereas the Board of Education intends to discuss matters as follows: personnel matters, and two, matters of attorney-client privilege. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the aforesaid subjects shall be discussed in closed session by this Board of Education and administrative staff. And the minutes of said closed session discussion will be made available to the public when the reasons for the non-disclosure in accordance with the Open Public Meetings Act no longer exist. Motion, please. Roll call.
Mr. Hush?
Yes.
Ms. Ortiz?
Yes.
Mr. Spencer?
Yes.
Ms. Varela?
Yes.
Mr. Caldwell?
Yes.
Mrs. Seewood?
Yes.
Motion approved. We are closed session.